know Girls vs. Boys is coming on?
Previously on Girls vs. Boys Hawaii.
Okay, in this competition, you guys are going to go hog wild.
Go, go,
go! Looking to go, Dina?
40 seconds!
Girls, you just picked up another 100 points.
Now, the first team to find their treasure and cross the finish line is going to walk away with another 100 points for their team.
These keys will unlock your final treasure, a treasure that's secretly locked to the palm trees to your left, a treasure that'll help you every day for the rest of the show. Your fourth teammate?
Craig!
What's up?
What up, bro?
I'm on your team now.
Hey! I know, y'all. Go!
All right, congratulations to the boys' team. Bring in another 100 points.
It's a little overwhelming. Everyone's really in-your-face personalities and really sort of talkative and loud, and I'm kind of a bit low-key sometimes.
Coming into this, I didn't know if I was going to, like, hook up with anyone. I don't have a boyfriend, but the guys are all pretty cute.
So Justin's looking to get some, affection.
Get up, man.
I think everyone here talks in their sleep. Jessica's like, she's following me. She's following me.
I think Jake will really help our team out. He may not be into sports as much as me, Chris, and Terry are, but you know, it hasn't all been athletic and competition, so hopefully he'll be able to help our team out in any way he can.
Can y'all hurry, please?
What?
I am really worried for the first competition because, like, if I screw up and it's totally my fault, they might not be so nice anymore.
It feels a little nerve-wracking, but we'll deal. It'll be cool.
So I am definitely, definitely feeling the pressure, and I'm actually very, very scared about screwing up.
Okay, we hear you guys have some money left over from last night.
This money is of absolutely no use to you in today's competition.
That's right. Today you guys have to earn your money.
Right. Now, as you guys know, there are a lot of tourists in Hawaii, and what better way for them to remember their trip than with some authentic Hawaiian souvenirs?
That's where you guys come in.
Right. Now, we have three different types of souvenirs. Each team is going to choose one to sell.
You're going to have half an hour to sell as much as you can. The team that makes the most money wins, and you're going to spend all of that cash, too. And the other teams.
Right, and they win big because today's competition is worth 200 points, which could put the boys in the lead for the very first time.
That's right, we double the point value. Now you're going to have these three gift items to choose from.
Right, some beautiful fish cologne.
Next we have a very beautiful and tasty rotted nani fruit.
Oh, all right, and then last but not least we have a beautiful bag of sand. Right. All right, now since the boys won the last competition, you get to pick first.
So what kind of?
I'm thinking the fish.
I'm thinking the fish or the sand. They're going to think duck.
They're going to be like, this hard.
So why don't we just get the sand? Because people collect that.
I'm thinking $5 would be, you know?
$5 for a bottle?
Right. And we're not going to set a set price. We're just going to be like, what we give us. Because some people may be like more generous than I am.
If we lose this, you know, it's going to be really crucial. It's going to be really hard to get back.
This is worth 200 points, so this is big.
Exactly. And I think this is my chance to kind of get a place in my team, so I'm gonna try my best.
Guys, I know this is my first competition with you, so is there anything I should know about how you guys work or what
this
can
is
I do?
This is pretty much all
this is pretty much
do,
like cooperation
and teamwork.
All right, guys, bring it in. Come here.
All right, guys, which did you choose?
We chose the soil cologne.
All right.
All right. There you go.
Ladies.
Girls?
We chose the sand.
Save. Right. Now remember, you guys have half an hour to sell as much as you can, all right? Are you ready? Get set.
Go.
Go.
Would you like to buy a bag of sand to beat the boys in the competition?
I have the whole beach with the sand.
We're selling fish cologne, but
can we do something crazy?
Oh,
let's do something crazy.
You'll get it?
What are you?
Wait, make them do something crazy.
I'll break this right here for you.
Oh, yeah.
Sand's better because it has, like, the black stuff in it.
It's rare.
And it's only from Hawaii.
You
put it on?
Put it on. Give me some. Will you buy some? How much?
Put it on?
How much? What?
How much would you be willing to pay for it?
Don't put that on me.
I watched that show last night and the girls beat the boys. I want the boys to win.
No!
The girls to win. Her husband at the beginning was like, no, we want her. I want the guys to win. We were like, no, we're trying to let the girls win this season. And the lady, the wife, which obviously wore the pants, I will give you $20.
$1 million, but I don't have $1 million.
We are glad to be selling fish oil cologne to you beautiful people on the beach of Hawaii. Okay, time, that's it. No more sales. I put on the cologne.
It was really hard at the beginning because it seemed like nobody had money, but then about maybe, what did you say, like 10 minutes in, we started getting a little bit more yeses.
Jake did really well in his first competition.
Literally just met him and he stepped up with confidence and just said everything, you know, we feel he did a great job.
But the best part was we did make it clear to everybody that the girls were dominating the boys and that we just had to prove to everybody that girls were stronger. It just physically,
all right, guys, great competition. You both sold your hearts out, but let's find out who won.
Guys, you sold a whopping $43. Way to go.
Ladies, you sold $70.90. You get not only this money, but the boys' money.
And that brings your score up to 700.
Woo!
To 400. We got some catching up to do, guys.
All right, you guys know about the whole money eating situation? That looks like a good meal you got right in front of you right there.
I'm shocked. I'm literally shocked.
Hey, I'm not around right now, so leave a message.
Please, I know you're there. Pick up.
Guys are kind of curious to see what the girls are going to do with the money since they won it today.
We're going to take her out to a really, really, really nice dinner, but
you knew that was going.
We got the 4 showers first.
That's really generous,
okay?
You guys.
That's very cool that the girls are treating us to dinner because they didn't have to. It's their money that they got from the competition. So it's very cool.
We're being so nice to the guys, right?
I know.
I love it.
They better.
Exactly.
Do I have to wear a shirt like this nice?
That looks nice.
No one else is
going to. You don't have to, but it would look really nice.
So I think this is a real opportunity to show them that we do care, you know, and we do congratulate them when they win, and we do feel sorry for them when they lose, and we're always there for them no matter what.
Put it around your neck, Jack. Don't put it all the way around.
Way back. But right now it's frantic out here.
Come on! Eat
it! Really kind of nervous right now. Trying to get as much as I can right now.
Jump, jump, jump! Let's go! Time. Definitely time.
Girls versus Boys.
Anyway,
Girls versus Boys is back. Gotta go.
Right here, bro.
Good job.
Right here, all of them.
Good job.
All good. Good.
Well, basically, the guys got their fourth person back sooner than we did. So they definitely had another person. So the only way that we could possibly win is if we stacked up more than they did and made the difference up. But we don't know how the results can turn out.
Good.
All right, congratulations, ladies. You brought back 48 pieces.
And boys, well, you guys did okay. 86.
Yeah!
Oh. Oh, woo.
Yes.
Woo. So that means no 200 points for you guys?
Yeah. Oh.
600 to 700, way to get back in the game, guys.
All right, and ladies, of course, we have a penalty. This is a penalty, David.
Tonight, you girls will be the boys' butlers.
I like that.
First win, finally feeling good. It got a bit of pressure off me and stuff. So.
This was the most important one, and he definitely helped us really
Everybody
well.
Stepped up today. It was good.
I feel bad just because I was the last person to go out there, and
don't feel bad.
Maybe we could have. No,
yeah.
But I do.
We
didn't time ourselves correct. You know, we didn't time ourselves right to go out there and then come back. You know, they did get an extra person. That's what really helped them. But yeah, that was totally why they had to win.
Just basically double what we had, which is like really, really awesome. Like to say that they didn't deserve to win.
Oh, they
like,
fully
totally
did. They didn't
be a lie. Like, they seriously deserved to win that one.
You know, the girls did pretty well. They even though we won this competition, they did their best.
We're still in the lead.
That's right. Look at that side, too. We still have the penalty, too.
I know that penalty.
Yeah, the penalty kind of sucked, but I don't know.
They did. Okay, it does really, really suck. But they did deserve their win, so whatever.
I can hear now. Can you go get me this to eat?
Can you rub
my
feet?
What if you're
going to
make
them
right?
Can you give me a foot massage?
I will not touch anything of them.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Stop that.
What do you guys want to do tonight about the penalty?
Okay, the problem is since they took us out for dinner last night, I feel bad about, you know, making them do something too bad. But, our rooms are clean.
All right, there you go.
So they can just, you know, do our beds,
clean the floor up, make the beds and look good.
Fold our clothes.
Caught even.
We sit there and they get us drinks.
Girls, excuse me. We have something to tell you.
No.
Are a little dirty right now.
No.
No, don't even start.
No, wait, I'm gonna clear this up. We are not a maid. paid, we're butler. That means we bring and make food and drink.
Our room's not bad.
Okay, we'll be lost.
Thanks, Lori. You are so great.
That's rude.
All right, come on. Let's just go. Let's just go, Phil. We're not going to do nothing for them anymore.
Don't push me.
No, it's not dirty. Look.
I don't know where to start. Is there a garbage can?
No, this room is so disgusting.
How do you make a bed?
No.
This is so messy.
No, get no. Bye. Bye.
Yo, the guys would like a drink right now.
No.
Bye.
No, one thing at a time, and if you snap your fingers, then it will be done, and bye.
Right? Okay, all right.
See, I told you guys we shouldn't come out to dinner last night.
What'd you do to it?
Thank you so much.
I'm shocked that they made us do that.
That's sad. I feel dumb.
It's okay. We'll just beat them tomorrow.
Yeah. You're good.
And then the one after that.
And then the one after that.
That'll probably pass.
There's absolutely nothing going on with Chris and I. I do not like him like that. And he's starting to get kind of annoying because, like, every time I want to hang out with someone else, he's always got to, like, cop up some attitude about, why are you talking to me? Why are you, you know, why did you give Justin a hug this morning and not me? And it's getting really annoying because it's kind of like, okay, you know what? I'm not your girlfriend. We're not together. So you should have absolutely no problem with me waking up and giving one of my guy friends a hug in the morning.
Every day it's a different attitude. It's like one day she'll be all over, the next day it's like not the same. It's like she won't talk to me the entire day. What really gets me angry is that she'll tell something to the camera about me and not tell me personally.
I've tried to say it in a nice way that I don't like you like that, and I've tried to say, you know, like, you know, be friends with him, but I don't know how to be, like, nice to him without him thinking it's more.
When I first came, I was so confused about what was going on with Chris and Jessica. I'm so confused. I think everyone's kind of confused. I don't know.
Ayo.
I think Justin's so sweet. He's such like a, he seems, I don't want to say like a mama's boy, because I don't think he is really, but he definitely does have a sensitive side, and I like that. I think it's really cute.
Still getting to know her right now, and I think everybody is. She's really calm and kind of got to get to know her, I guess, to talk to us, what Jake says, so I don't know, it's cool. I'll just see what happens.
As far as like a fling or whatever, I guess, I don't know, I like to take the attitude of whatever happens, happens.
Shut up!